Let's understand exactly how to configure a Teams meeting. Few senior people, maybe some external guests are going to present, and lots of internal people are going to attend. I regularly conduct large sessions for many customers, and invariably the meeting is never configured properly. While creating the meeting, add the co-organizers and presenters. Next, go to meeting options. The most important thing is to select at least one co-organizer. There are certain things which only organizers and co-organizers can do. This is an internal meeting, so just disable the lobby. To select, everyone can bypass the lobby. Next, configure who can present. Keep number of presenters to a minimum. So if it is internal presenters, select specific people and then select their names. If it is external presenters, just choose only organizers and co-organizers can present. Let the external presenters join during the meeting and then promote them as presenters. I strongly recommend that by default, you should disable microphone and video for all attendees. We can still encourage interaction by asking people to raise hands and selectively allowing them mic and video. I prefer that audience types their question rather than asks it, because then they can put the question as soon as it comes to their mind. And as a presenter, I also have more flexibility of skipping some questions, prioritizing them, combining multiple questions, and so on. For typing the questions, we have two options, chat and Q&A. I recommend you use chat. Q&A, people are not familiar and it's more confusing than convenient. Now our meeting is properly configured. Remember, during the meeting, any of these settings can be changed even after the meeting has started. So try this out and let me know if this is useful to you. Also, watch this video to understand how to manage entire meeting lifecycle more effectively.